Hello friends, get your pen and paper and find the square of below numbers. No matter how good you are in the calculation, you will at least take 15 seconds to get an answer. But after watching this video, you can find the square of any number in less than 3 seconds. You can see how quickly I'm going to find the square of below numbers. Square of 98 is 9604. Square of 102, 10404, 506, 256, 036, and square of 979 is 958441. I can guarantee you that you can get answer as quick as I got. The only condition is that you have to watch this video till end carefully. Each and every step in this video is equally important, so please do not miss any bit of this video. So friends, let's get started. So friends, we are going to divide our square finding methods into four major methods. So first one, with first one you can find square of any number that ends with 5. With second method you can find out the square of any 2-digit number. With the third method, numbers which are close to 50, 100, 500, 1000, you can find square of such numbers. And with fourth method you can find out square of any number, any damn number. I call it as a universal trick. The prerequisite, like, you know, you should know the square of number 1 to 25. That's our recommendation. If you remember square of 1 to 25, your calculations will become real faster. So let's start with our first method, that is square of any number that ends with 5. Let's take an example, 35. So we are going to find out the square of 35. So what you're going to do, you will take the unit digit number that is 5 and you will write the square of that as it is, which is 25. Now, the another number at the first digit is 3. So I'll just write the next consecutive number of 3, which is 4. We are simply going to multiply 3 into 4, that is 12. So 1225 is your answer. Let's take another example, 85. So if you have to find square of 85, so you'll first write 25, which is the square of unit digit number. Then the next consecutive number for 8 is 9, so 8 into 9 is 72. 7225 is my answer. So this method is very, very simple. And with this method, any number which ends with 5, you can find out square of such number very quickly. So moving to our second method, where we can find out the square of any 2-digit number. Let's take an example, 31. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to make 3 places like this. So in the first place, I'm going to write square of the unit digit, that is 1. Third place, I'm going to write the square of the 10-digit, that is 3. And in the middle place, I'm going to multiply 3 into 1, that is this 2-digit, with 2. So how you can remember 3 into 1 into 2? So square of 1 is 1, 3 into 2 into 1 is 6, and square of 3 is 9. So 961 is my answer. Square of 31 is 961. Let's take another example, 63 square. So again, the same method, 1, 2, 3 places. Square of 3 is 9, square of 6, 36. 6 into 3 into 2. 3 into 2. So it's 6 into 3 is 18 into 2, 36. So my answer is 9. This 6, I'm going to write it as it is. And this 3 carry over, 36 plus 3, 39. So 3969 is the square of 63. So all these calculations, so what I'm doing here, that should happen actually in your mind. Once you practice well, you can easily do that. Let's take another example, 77. So square of 77 1, 2, 3. So 7 square is 49. Again 7 square is 49. So 7 into 7, 49 into 2 is 98. So my answer should be 9. 98 plus 4 is 102. I'm writing 2 over here. 10 carry. So 49 plus 10, 59. So 5929 is my answer. So friends, you can see how easily we can find out square of any 2-digit number. Let's move to our third method, where we can find out the square of any number which are close to 50, 100, 500, 1000. Let's take example 51, square of 51. What I'm going to do, I'm going to find out the difference between 50 and the number. So 51 is plus 1 with respect to 50. I'm going to write 25 over here, which is a square of 5, 25. So you should remember this figure when you are finding square of the number which is close to 50. So 25 plus 1 is 26, and the square of 1, I'm going to always represent it in 2 digits, 01. So 2601 is my answer. The square of 51 is 2601. Let's take another example, 53. So again, 25, 53 is plus 3, so 25 plus 3 is 28, and square of 3 is 09. So square of 53 is 2809. This is the simplest method to find out square of any number which is close to 50. Let's take example where we are short of 50, so 49. So 49 is 1 short to 50. I'm writing 25 here. The same method, 25 minus 1 is 24, and square of 1 is 01. So 2401 is my answer. You can see just by looking at a number, I can really write down the square. So another example, 43 square. So 43 is 7 short, 25. 25 minus 7 is 18, and square of 7 is 49. So 1849 is my answer. The same method you can apply for 100 as well. So let's take example where I want to find out the square of 99. So 99 is 99 square. So here there is big change. It's kind of same method, but the formula you are going to apply has changed. So you are always going to find out the difference of 99 with respect to 100, that is minus 1. And what you are going to do, we are going to minus this 1 from the 99 itself. So 99 minus 1 is 98, and square of 1. So square of 1 is 01. So 9801 is my answer. So let's take another example where I want to find square of the number which is less than 100. Let's take 94 square. So 94 is 6 short. So 94 minus 6 is 88, okay, and square of 6 is 36. So 8836 is my answer. The same method you can apply for the numbers which are greater than 100. So let's take 102 square. So 102, you can write plus 2. So 102 plus 2 is 104, and square of 2 is 04. 10404 is my answer. Let's take another example, 112 square. So here it's plus 12. So 112 plus 12 is 124, and square of 12 is 144. What I'm going to do, I'm always going to write as the two places. So I'll write 44, this one carry over, which will become 125. So 125/44 is my answer. The same method you can apply for 500 and thousands as well. I'll take one quick example where I want to find out the square of 502. So if it is 5, I was taking 25. So in case of 500, I'm going to take 250, and the difference is plus 2. So I'm going to write 252, and square of 2 is 4. Since I'm going to find out the square of 3-digit number, I'll write a 004. So 252004 is my answer. The same applies for 1000 as well. So with this method, you can see, like, you know, any number which is close to 50, 100, 500, 1000, you can find out the answer, you know, in less than 3 seconds, this is the fastest method to find out square of any number. So friends, moving to the last method of this session, that is finding square of any number. This method you should apply for a complicated number. I call it as a universal trick because you can find square of any number using this method. Let's take one example. I want to find out the square of 414. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to find out the closest number to 414 of which I know the square. So that number is 400. I'm going to represent this 414 in terms of 400. So it is 414 minus 14, which will be 400. I will multiply this with 414 plus 14. The number which I have reduced, 14, I'm going to add that plus 14 square, which is my formula. So 414 minus 14 is 400. 414 plus 14 is 428 plus 14 square is 196. Now this 428 I can represent it as 400 plus 28, just to simplify the calculation. So 400 into 400, I'll write it 16 and 4 zeros. 28 into 4, so I'm writing this 2 zeros, and 28 into 4 is 112 plus 196, which is my answer. So 6, 9, 2 plus 1, 3, 1, 6 plus 1, 7, and 1. So 171, 396 is the square of 414. Let's take another example. I'm going to find square of 722. So here the closest number is 700. So what I'm going to do, 722 minus 22 into 722 plus 22. Add 22 and square of 22. So this is 700 into 744, which I can write 700 plus 44 plus 22 square is 484. So this 49, 700 into 700 is 49, 0, 0, 0, 0, this 4 zeros. 700 into 44 will be 7 into 4, 28, carry 2, 7 into 4, 28 plus 2, 30, and 484. So my answer is 488 plus 4, 12, carry 1, 9 plus 3, 12, carry 1, 5. 521, 284 is the square of 722. With this example, you can see, like, you know, this is such a complicated number. With the orthodox way, you should have taken much time to calculate the square. But with this method, you can find square very easily. Now coming to the next point, where which method to choose. So you should always choose the square finding method wisely. For example, let's say you have to find the square of 979. So let's find out the square using this universal trick. So 979 is close to 1000, so I can represent it as 979 plus 21 and 979 minus 21 plus 21 square. So this is 1000. 979 minus 21 is 958 plus 21 square is 441. Now if you can see, my answer is 958 0, 0, 0 plus 441, and 958 441 is my answer. So if you see, like, you know, 1, 2, 3 steps I have done to reach this answer. If you remember our third method, where we were finding the square of any number which are close to 50, 100, 1000. So if you apply that method, you can simply see 979 is 21 short. So basically the 21 you should reduce from 979. So 979 minus 21 and the square of 21. So it's simply 958441 is my answer. You can get it in just one step. So that's what I'm saying. You should apply your square finding method very much wisely so that you can save the time. That's all about all these methods to find the square.